Your vehicle has a standard cruise control function, but did you know that it has an additional feature that's designed to help you drive more efficiently and save your vehicle energy too? It's called EcoCruise. It works a lot like standard cruise control in that it still maintains your speed on flat roadways. But with EcoCruise, when you tap the brake and then want to resume your previously set speed, it accelerates gradually to get your vehicle back up to speed, and that can help save energy. Be aware that you may experience some speed loss when first going uphill, but after a short period of time, it will catch up to your set speed. And if equipped with adaptive cruise control, when your vehicle speed is slowed, it will automatically accelerate again gradually once traffic is cleared. That gradual acceleration may make it seem as if your vehicle isn't keeping up with the speed you've set. It is. It's just that it's more efficient to gradually accelerate. When EcoCruise is on, but not active, the Eco and Car icon in your information display will be gray. Once active, both Eco and the Car icon will turn green. Now, just accelerate to the speed you want, then press the Set button on the left side of your steering wheel. Your vehicle will keep a constant speed until you brake. Keep in mind, if you do brake, but then want to resume your set speed again, you can press the Resume button on the left side of your steering wheel. If at any time you want a quick refresher on what this feature is, scroll to Information, use the 5-way control on the left side of your steering wheel, go to the main menu, Tutorial, then select EcoCruise, and a brief description will appear. Of course, if you'd rather not use the EcoCruise feature, it can be turned off using the 5-way controls on the left side of your steering wheel, and scrolling to Settings in your information display. Driver Assist, EcoCruise, then off. When EcoCruise has been turned off, the next time you set a cruising speed, you'll be using standard cruise control. Any questions? Go to FordOwner.com.